Flashfig is a tiny software tool to help you apply your configurations on routers without even having to log in. It is designed for Windows, but it can be used on Linux as well. I won't cover the tool in detail, as you can learn about it both from the help page and from the other Flashfig video where I demonstrate the usage from Windows. This time, we will simply get Linux to run it correctly. If you are a host with just one interface, then things are pretty simple. All you need to do is set an IP address from the same network that you will use as a client address on the tool and launch it with Wine. However, if you have multiple interfaces, even if they are not physical interfaces such as bridges, the packets typically don't get routed correctly and the tool fails. So I'm going to show you how to fix this. The very first thing that you want to do is stop the network manager service, because if you don't, it will be messing with your physical links and the related network configuration. For example, it could disable the link that you are trying to configure and remove the IP address that you just set through the terminal. I'm actually in a virtual machine here, so that could be a solution in itself if you want to continue using your other network interfaces while working with Flashfig. All you have to do is create a virtual machine with one interface that taps the correct port on your host. For demonstration purposes, this machine has two interfaces. The first one is for internet access and the other one is for connecting to other devices. I have a default route that has been automatically set through the DHCP client, and as you can see, I have internet access. But unfortunately, if I set the IP address on my other interface, it will not work correctly even if I put the main interface in a down state. If you launch the tool now, it will look something like this. No messages in the main window, but errors in the terminal. Now let's close it and add a default route to the gateway address, which we are using as the boot client address in Flashfig. And a nice little thing we can do here is to set the metric value to 0. If you still have other routes that are conflicting, for example, a default route to another interface that you still have running, then your system will prefer the route with the lowest metric value. And then I just need to set the boot device back to flash boot, because obviously I just powered on my router, which automatically changed the boot device. I can now run Flashfig using Wine and sudo privileges, and of course it will be successful. All our packets are getting routed to our only enabled interface, and we get the Flashfig message after a few seconds of waiting. That's all there is to it.